organized it as a fight for the gold medal of Olympics in football. And the match is between Brazil and Spain. And come on, everybody predicted that it will be Brazil and Spain that will get into the finals of this football Olympics. And that's what happened. And we have to see that who's going to win it. Is it going to be Brazil, who won the gold medal in 2016 Olympics? Or is it Spain, who last won the gold medal in 1992 Barcelona Games? But listen to this, other than that 1992 gold medal that Spain has won, they have two silver medals in Olympics. But on the other hand, Brazil has three silver medals, two bronze medals and one gold medal. Wow. And not only that, in 2008 Olympics, Brazil won the bronze medal. In 2012 Olympics, Brazil won the silver medal. Then in 2016 Olympics, Brazil won the gold medal. Talk about consistency. They did it throughout. So do you think that they won't be getting a medal this time? Because come on, Brazil has a lot of chance to do that, but cannot take Spain lightly because they have one of the best squads there could be in these Olympics of football. So I think that it's going to be a very interesting match. And I've already made a video of football at Summer Olympics. In case you've not seen this, I'll put the link in the description box below. You can go ahead and watch that in case you have any doubt about football at Summer Olympics. So this time the squad is below the age of 24 and three overage players are allowed. So three overage players of Spain are Marco Asensio, Mikel Merino and Dani Ceballos. On the other hand, in Brazil's squad, the overage players are Dani Alves, Santos and Diogo Carlos. Before going into the match, some of the facts are both the teams have conceded 3 goals and they scored 8 goals. Also, Dani Ceballos suffered an ankle injury against Egypt, so he might not be available today. And I don't think that he's available today. There's very, very less chance of that. Unai Simón, the goalkeeper of Spain, if manages to keep a clean sheet today, will beat Santos, the goalkeeper of Brazil, to Golden Glove. Richarlison, the Brazilian who plays for Everton, he is the top goal scorer till now. He's at 5 goals and can challenge for Golden Boot in this match for sure. There's a lot at stake because Spain has not won a gold medal since 1992 and the last Olympic medal that they won was back in 2000, which was a silver medal. And they have not won anything in Olympics since then. But on the other hand, Brazil has been winning a lot of medals in Olympics. So they are the reigning champions. They would really want to retain that because till now, only 5 countries have done that. They have managed to retain their gold medals. Let's see if Brazil will do that or not. And you know the drill, I'll meet you in halftime and then full time. So stay tuned. It's halftime and the scoreline is 1-0 in favor of Brazil. They got the goal in the added time of the first half. Now the thing is that the match was going quite evenly. It's 50% possession and the shots that Brazil has had, it's 5 and Spain has had only 2 shots till now. But it's Brazil that is looking more connected and into the game. So there's a possibility that Brazil might win it. By the way, Brazil were awarded a penalty kick at 38th minute and Richarlison came up to take the penalty, but he could not convert it because Matheus Cunha, who has had a very good Olympic tournament, ended up converting it for Brazil because I think that that was a very poor defending from Spain's side and they could have cleared it better. But Matheus Cunha took the chance and he striked it beautifully and that is how Brazil got the first goal. And also Cunha has already registered 2 goals for Brazil and this is going to be his 3rd goal and I think he has had a pretty good this Olympic tournament. By the way, Diogo Carlos made a acrobatically good save, otherwise it could have easily been 1-0 in favor of Spain. By the way, this is going to be Pedri's almost 73rd or 74th game and he's just 18 years old. 73rd or 74th game in this year. Oh my god, just give him a gold medal for that, seriously. Just 18 years old and playing so incredibly good. Let's see what happens in second half, but overall this is what is going on in the match. Let's see if Spain gets more aggressive in second half and comes up with something from their arsenal and ends up making a comeback in this game, and then let's see if that happens or not. I just have to say this, that Neeraj Chopra has won the gold medal for India. So first gold medal for India in this Tokyo Olympic 2020. And I couldn't be more proud. So happy that he has won it. So happy. Clearly deserve it. Now getting back into the football. The match is over and Brazil has won it. They were the reigning champions. And now they have become the 6th country to have retained their gold medal in Olympics. This is crazy and I'm so happy for Brazil because they actually tried a lot and they were a better team here, no doubt about that. They linked more, the link-up pace between them worked more. Spain seemed a little bit disoriented and staggered. I think that is why it did not work for them. But a special mention to Oyarzabal, who equalized it for Spain, and his goal was sensational. Seriously, it was very good. After 90 minutes, the match ended in a 1-1 draw, and later on had to go in extra time. And in that, Malcolm ended up scoring, or maybe sealing the victory, or sealing this gold medal for Brazil, and they have done it. And now they are the champions. They have won this Olympics gold again. And I think it's good for Spain too that they are back to winning Olympic medals. Because the last medal that they won in any category, be it gold, silver or bronze, was back in 2000, and that was a silver medal. So I think after 20 years, winning a silver medal and getting back into that groove is a very good thing for Spain. So obviously it's not gold, but it's something. And I think Pedri and the rest of the team, they completely deserve that. And that is it. So Olympics football is over. And I just hope that these players get some really big holiday, because many of them were involved in Copa America as well as Euros. So come on, that's really hectic. So that is it from me today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.